Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes. Yes, so today's class is a continuation of yesterday's class. What did we do yesterday? We discussed previous Olympiad questions from numbers, yes. So this is the part 2, okay. So first listen to that video and then listen this, okay children. Starting with the first question for today. This is a place value chart for. Now what do we have here? Just simply what to write is. What to do with this question here? Just see which number below is having the digits in the same order as here. 130256. Yes, option B is the correct answer. Okay, and also look at the commas. Commas should be after the end of period. Now, ones period is ending at 2. So, place a comma there. And the thousands period is ending at 3. So, again a comma there. Yes, this is very simple question. Next. Tick the correct statement. Statement A. The place value of a 6-digit number is lakhs in the place value chart. Statement B. The place value of a 6-digit number is thousands in the place value chart. What are they talking about? 6-digit number. So let us see where does the place value of a 6-digit number come. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes. So the place value of a 6-digit number is lakhs. So which statement becomes correct? Statement A is correct, that is option A. Yes, it is not the thousands place, only statement A is correct. Okay children, next question. Again tick the correct statement. Statement A. If we add 1 to the largest 5 digit number, we will get the smallest 6 digit number. Statement B. If we add 1 to the largest 4 digit number, we will get the smallest 6 digit number. Now how? If you look at statement 1, adding 1 to the largest 5 digit number, will it give us the smallest 6 digit number? Yes, it is correct. But statement 2, adding 1 to the largest 4 digit number, will not give us the smallest 6 digit number. It will give us the smallest 5 digit number. So again, only statement A is correct, that is option A. Next question. Place value of 5 in 654,321 is dash. Now first write the place values. Yes children, now 5 is in which place? 10,000. 5 is in 10,000's place. So what will it become? 5 into 10, 50. So the place value becomes 50,000. Option C, 50,000 is the correct answer. Next, again tick the correct statement. Statement A, 534,237 is equal to 534,237. And in statement B, the same number, instead of commas, you are putting hyphens. Now, we have learned in the previous class, yes, children, instead of commas, we can leave some space, but not hyphens. We can leave some space. So, only option statement A is correct, that is option A. Yes, statement B is wrong. We can put either full stop or else space instead of commas. Next, in Roman numeration, there are only dash basic numerals. What are the numerals in Roman numeration system? IVX, LC, DM. Yes, how many are these? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, there are only 7 basic Roman numerals. Yes or no, children? With these, we will form many other numerals. Next. The basic numeral, that Roman numeral that can never be subtracted is. Now if you remember the rules, V, L, N, D. V, L, N, D can never be subtracted. Now of these which are present in the options, both V and D are present. So option C and option D become our correct answer. These two can never be subtracted. Next question. The Roman numeral for 5 is, we know right, IVX. So I is 1, V is 5 and X is 10. So V stands for 5, that is option D here. Very easy question, right children? Yes. The Roman numerals from which I can be subtracted are V and, if you remember how I taught you this, these are the Roman numerals that we have. So, I can be subtracted from only the next two numerals, that are V and X. I can be subtracted from V and X. Option B, X is our correct answer. In the same way, wait a second, IVX, LCDM, yes. So in the same way, L can be subtracted from only C and D. Okay, children, so in the I can be subtracted from V and X, L can be subtracted from C and D. Next question, the ascending order of XX, XXX, VI and V is dash. Now, to find out the ascending, what is the ascending order? If you remember, ascending, here A is the smallest alphabet, yes. So, in ascending order, we arrange the numbers from the smallest to the greatest. Yes, or what did I say? We are having S in the ascending order. S means small. So, in ascending order, we arrange the numbers from the smallest to greatest. Let us convert these into Indo-Arabic numerals first. XX becomes 10 plus 10, that is 20. XXX is 30. VI is 6. So, 30 plus 6 becomes 36. V is 5. 20, 36 and 5. So, what will be the ascending order? Smallest is 5. So, 5 comes first. Then we have 20 and 36. V, XX, XXX, VI. This is the ascending order of the given numerals. That is the same as option C. Yes, children, 5, 20 and 36. Next, the Roman numeral for 24 is dash. Now, how to write this 24? It can be split as 20 plus 4. Now, 20 can be written as XX and 4 is written as IV. So, XXIV, that is option B, is the Roman numeral for 24. Next, PQR are the Roman numerals, each having V only once and in the place shown. Other two Roman numerals are I and X. Now, what can be said about P, Q and R? What are they saying here? This P, Q and R are three Roman numerals. Yes, in P, the first place is occupied by V. And in Q, the second place is occupied by V. And in R, the third place is occupied by V. Now, in the other two places, I and X can be used. Okay, children? In the other two places, I and X can be used. Now, we should find out first what can these Roman numerals be. Now, when I say V, I, X, what will this be? 5 plus, this is not, yes, this is not the correct way to write V, I, X. Let us look at first Q and R. Now, what can Q and R be? See, it can be XVI. XVI means what? 10 plus 6. That is equal to 16. Or what can it be? XIV. XIV means what, children? See, XIV means 10 plus IV is what? 5 minus 1. That is 10 plus 4. That is equal to 14. Now, what did we find out about Q and R? Q is XVI, that is 16, and R is XIV, that is 14. Now coming to P, the only two possible combinations are this, VIX or VXV. Yes, children, if you come to VXV, now this becomes 10 minus 5. Yes or no? Yes. So, this is not possible here. We cannot subtract 5. We can never subtract V. So VXI cannot be possible. Now coming to VIX, how can we put this? This is 5. Yes, and this will become 9. 5 plus 9 is equal to 13. But this is wrong. This is not the way we write 13. We write 13 like this. Yes or no? Yes. So again, this is also not possible. So from this, what we learn is that we cannot use both X and I together here. Now, this P can be VX or VI. Sorry, VX is not possible, right? So, VX is, both X and I cannot be used here. So, we can use only one, either X or either I. Now, if you write VX, it becomes 10 minus 5. Now, this is not possible. So, the only possible option is VI, that is equal to 6. Okay, children, what is it? It is VI, that is equal to 6. So, the value of P is 6. Clear? Yes, because we cannot be subtracted, that is why we are left with only 6 here. Now, what can be said about P, Q and R? Now, Q and R represent the same number. Do they? No. Q is 16 and R is 14. Now, the next one is Q is larger than R and P. Now, Q is the larger than R and P. Yes or no? Yes, it is the largest. It is larger than both R and P. Option C, R is the largest. Is R the largest number? No, Q is the largest number. So, C is wrong. Option D, the difference between Q and R is 2. 16 minus 14. Is it 2 or not? Yes. So, B and D are the correct statements here. Yes, option B and D are the correct statements. Next question, using the table given below, answer the following question. Now, M dash 1000. Now, M is equal to 1000. Yes, so, M 100. Now, we are comparing M with 100 here. What is M? They have given the table for us. M is 1000. Now, 1000 is the bigger number. So, if you remember, children, 1000 is the bigger number. So, open your mouth towards 1000. 1000 is larger than 100. That is option A becomes our correct answer. Yes? Next, the jar shows rounded figure. How many marbles could be there in the jar? Now, 200 is what is our rounded figure or the estimate. The estimated to the nearest tens or hundreds. Now, coming to the given options. Now, which can be, how many marbles could be there in the jar? Now, if you take option A, 195. If you round it off to the nearest hundreds, children. Yes, 9 here is greater than 5. So, we round up. 1 plus 1 becomes 2 and then zeros. So, 200. So, 195 can be rounded off as 200. Or even if we take 240. Yes. Now, for rounding off to hundreds, we look at the digit in tens place, right? Yes. So, this 4 is less than 5. So, we round down 2 written as it is and then 2 zeros. So, both option A and B, that is, it can be 195 or 240. Yes, but if they say specifically that the jar shows the rounded figure to the nearest tens, yes, to the nearest tens, then 195 becomes our answer. Because 195 rounded off to the nearest tens is 200. But as they did not give anything, we are assuming that it is rounded off to the nearest hundreds. And option A and B are both our correct answers. Next, which of the following statements can be true about these four numbers? Option A. A is the largest of all the other numbers. Now, if you look at the numbers, children, yes, the first two digits are the same. Now, coming to the third digits, we have 0, 9, 5 and 9. Now, of these, we are talking about A. A is having 0 in the third place. Now, is it the largest of all? No, it is the smallest of all the numbers. So, A is wrong. Next, D is the smallest of all the other numbers. Just now we have discussed that A is the smallest. So, again, D is not the smallest of all. Option C, A is the smallest of all the other numbers. Yes, that is what we have discussed. A is having 0 in the tens place. So, it is the smallest number of all. Coming to option D, C is the largest of all other numbers. Now, C is having 5 here, but B and D are having 9. So, these can be the larger ones, but not C. So, again, option D is our wrong answer. Only C is the correct answer. Next, the ascending order of 9411, 9145, 9015 and 9149 is dash. Now again, ascending order from smallest to the greatest. Yes, children, here all the first digits are same. Going to the second digits, 4101. Now the smallest is 0. So, 9015 becomes our correct answer. If you look at the options, children, only option B is having 9015 in the first place. That is, it is having 9015 as the smallest number. So, even without solving the others, we can say that option B is the correct answer. Okay? In Olympiad exams, you need to be fast and solve as many questions as possible. So, check whether you can find the answer with the first one only. Now if you go for solving the whole problem, next we have these two numbers which are having one in the hundreds place. Yes, so the first two digits are same, going to the third digit, again 4 and 4 same, going to the last digit, this is having 5 and this is having 9. Now 5 is the lesser number, right? So 9145 will be written first, then 9149, and lastly we are left with 9411. So this will be our ascending order. Clear, children? Option B is the correct answer. Next, 73842 has dash. No, 30 hundredths. What are they saying? It has 30 hundredths. No, it is not having 30 hundredths. It is having 8 hundredths. Next, 30 thousandths. Does it have 30 thousandths? No, it has 3 thousandths. Next, 2 tens. Is it having 2 tens? No, children. It is having 2 ones. And option D is 30 tens. No, it is not having 30 tens, but it is having 3 thousandths. Now, what can be the correct answer here? I think here some option is given wrong. If we take option B as 3 thousandths, then option B becomes our correct answer. Okay, I think there is some problem in the option given. So 73,842 has 3 thousandths. Next, a city has a population of 81,521. What is 81,521 rounded off to the nearest 100? 81521. Yes, this is what rounded off to the nearest 100. Look at the digit in tens place. It is less than 5. So rounding down, 815 written as it is, and the last two digits replaced by zeros. 81,500. Is our correct answer, rounded off to the nearest 10. Next question. The largest 5-digit number having 0 at 10's place and without repeating the digits is dash. Now, this is talking about only the given options, children. So, in the given options, look for the number which is having 0 at 10's place. Now, B and D are having 0 at 10's place. Yes or no? Yes. Now, of these two, we have to find out the largest number. Now, if we compare 97,806 and 98,706, first digits are same. Going with the second digit, 7 and 8. Which is the larger number? 8. So, 98,706, that is option D, becomes our largest 5-digit number here. Next, 7,900 is same as. See, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 7 in the thousands place and 9 in the hundreds place. Remaining places are zeros. So 7900 is same as 7900, that is option B. Okay. Next, the difference between the place value of 8 and 0 in 78,045 is dash. Now, what do we know about zero's place value, children? No matter in whatever place 0 is, its place value will always be equal to 0. So we know that the place value of 0 is 0 here. Coming to the place value of 8, it is in thousands place. So its place value becomes 8 thousands or 8000. So what should we do? We should find out the difference. Difference means subtraction. So subtract 0 here. What is 0? It is the place value of 0. So, if you remember about subtracting with 0, when we subtract 0 from any number, what will be the answer? The answer will be the same as the number itself. So, 8000 minus 0 is equal to 8000 only. That is option C. Yes? Next question. Using 90524 digits only once, answer the following question. Smallest 5-digit number is dash. Now, using these numbers, we should find out the smallest 5-digit number. Yes, children, if you remember how to form the smallest 5-digit number, first arrange the numbers in the ascending order from small to big, 0, 2, 4, 5 and 9. Now, this number 0, 2, 4, 5, 9 cannot be called as what? A 5 digit number. 0 is in the first place, so it becomes a 4 digit number. Now what we'll do? We'll just replace. We'll just switch places of 0 and 2 here. 2 comes first and then comes 0. 20459 becomes our smallest 5 digit number. That is option A. Clear, children? Next question. What can be said about the Roman numeral V? Now, what do we know about V? V is equal to 5. Yes. So, let us look at the options. Option A. It is never repeated. Yes. Is this true about V, children? Yes. V can never be repeated. And option B. It is never subtracted. Just as we have done in this class only, that V can never be subtracted. And apart from V, L and D also can never be subtracted. So both are correct. Coming to option C, it is never repeated, but it can be subtracted. No, it cannot be subtracted. So C is wrong. And option D, it is never repeated and never subtracted. Yes, option D is correct. It is the combination of both A and B. So what can we say about Roman numeral V, children? That it is never repeated and it can never be subtracted. Yes. Next question. A man always shows his fingers as shown in the figure. It represents the Roman numeral. What is the shape of this? It is in the shape of V. Yes, it is in the shape of V. So what Roman numeral does it represent? Option A, 5. Yes, V is equal to 5. So these two fingers represent the Roman numeral 5. Okay, children. Going to the next question. Anita's age is 48 years. Express it in Roman system. 48. Now how to write this? Split it up. 40 and 8. Now 40 is written as 50 minus 10. Now what I suggest is, whenever you have to convert a number into a Roman numeral, first write the Roman numbers and their values. Yes, 1, 5, 10, 50 and 100. Now, here 50 minus 10 means what? L and X. Now, how should we write that? If we need to subtract the smaller number to the left, XL. XL becomes 40. And coming to 8, 8 can be written as 5 plus 3. Now, 5 is V and 3 is 3 ones, III. So, XLVIII is our 48 in Roman numerals. Now, which is the correct answer here? Option C, XLVIII is the correct answer. Okay, children, moving on to the next question. Hindu Arabic numeral for MMM, CCC, XXX, III is dash. Now, again, just as I said, now we have to convert this Roman numeral into Hindu Arabic numeral. So, better we write the chart first. What are we considered about I and X? We know that I is 1 and X is 10. Yes, children, L, C, D, M. Now, L is 50, C is 100, D is 500. Sorry, we want only this, right? M is what? M is 1000, C is 100, X is 10 and I is 3. Now, we are having 3 M's. It becomes 1000. Plus 1000 plus 1000, that is equal to 3000. Yes, children. Next, 3 C's. 3 C's means what? 300. 100 plus 100 plus 100 is equal to 300. And then XXX, that is equal to 10 plus 10 plus 10, that is equal to 30. And lastly, III is equal to 3. Now, when we add all of these together, what do we get? 3, 3, 3, 3. So, 3333 is our correct answer. That is option C. Okay, children? Moving on to the next question. Raghu is 21 years old and Kavita is 22 years old. Write the sum of their ages in the Roman system. What are there? 21 and 22. So, when we add 3 and 4, what is the answer? It is 43. Now, 43 can be written as 40 plus 3. Just now in the previous question, what did we do? 40, we got it as XL. That is nothing but 50 minus 10. Yes, children? Now coming to 3, III. So XLIII becomes 43. That is option B. Coming to the next question, the number name for 5008 is, I have only said it, 5 is in thousands place and 8 is in ones place. So it becomes 5000. 5 in thousands place becomes 5000 and 8 in ones place becomes 8. So option A, 5008 is the correct answer. Next, the expanded form of 45010 is dash. Now after 4 we are having 4 digits. So after 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros plus after 5 we are having 3 digits. So 3 zeros plus 0 plus after 1 we have 1 digit and then 0. So 40,000 plus 5,000 plus 0 plus 10 plus 0 is our answer. Let us look at the options. It is 4,000 plus 500. No, it should be 40,000 plus 5,000. Next, we have 40,000 plus 1,000. No, right children, it should be 40,000 plus 5,000. Coming to C, it is 45,000 plus 0 plus 10. Now, this is the same as our question only, right? Instead of 40 and 50, combinedly they have written as 45,000 plus 0 plus 10. So, option C can be our right answer. Let us look at option D as well. 4,000 plus 5,000 plus 0 plus 10 plus 0. It is not 4,000 but it is 40,000. So option D also becomes our wrong answer. Option C is the correct answer. Okay. Next, the smallest 6 digit number using the digits 204571 is dash. Again, just now we have done arrange the digits in ascending order, that is from small to big. 012457. Now what should we do? Interchange the first two places. 102457. So this becomes our smallest 6 digit number. 102,457. That is option C. Yes children. Now again, why can't 0 be in the starting? Because when 0 is in the start, it is of no use for us. It has no value. So it becomes a 5 digit number. But we want a 6 digit number. That is why we have placed 0 second. Next question. The numeral for 400,404 in international place value chart is dash. Now 1000. This 400,000. Now this is in the thousands period. In thousands period we have 400. So it becomes 400,000. And then after that we have 404. So this will be our... What do you say children? The numeral in international place value chart. Okay. 400 is in thousands period. So 400, comma, then 404 is in the ones period. So 400,404. Option B becomes our correct answer. Next question. The greatest 7 digit number is dash. Now again, how to write the greatest 7 digit number? First make 7 places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The first digit should be 0 and the remaining digit should be, the first digit should be 1 and the remaining digits should be zeros. So this 10 lakhs becomes our smallest 7 digit number, that is option A. Okay children, next question. A, B, C and D are 4 digit numbers, each having the digit 9 only once and in the place shown. None of the digits are known. This is in case of incomplete question, I think, children. Yes, they are just saying us about what is given in the options. These are 4 digit numbers and they are having 9, that two only ones, and also in the place that is shown here. Yes, so 9 cannot come in any other place than this, in this number. So what should we find out about this now? I think that we should... See, this is an incomplete question, so I am thinking that we need to find out the greatest number of these all. Yes, we need to find out what? We need to find out the greatest number of it all. So I think option A will be the correct answer. Why? See, the number greater, is there any single digit number greater than 9? No, 9 is the greatest one digit number. So after 9, there can be no other digit here that is greater than 9. So obviously 9 option A becomes our correct answer. And also remember that 9 can be used only once. Yes, so 9 is already used here. So 9 cannot come in the first place. So in that way, option A becomes our correct answer. In case in your exam, in your Olympiad exam, if you get any incomplete questions like this or something else, do answer the question, okay? Children, write any option because they will give you grace marks for that, okay? Because the examiner has given the wrong question and it is his fault. So we'll get marks for whatever option we place, okay? So in this, even if I write option B, C or D also, I'll get full marks. Why? Because the question is incomplete here. So in the exam, don't forget to mark the answer for such type of incomplete questions. Next, the last question for today. If one, let us say rhombus. Yes, this is rhombus. Yes, so one rhombus is 100. Then this represents what? Let us count how many rhombuses are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How many? 8 rhombuses. And 1 is equal to 100. Then 8 becomes what? 8 into 100. That is nothing but 8 ones are 8. And then 2 zeros, 800. So these 8 rhombuses represent 800. That is option D. Clear, children? So with this, we have come to the end of today's class. And we've completed all the previous Olympiad questions from the topic numbers. Yes, I hope today's class was clear, children. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.